So hello everyone, we are glad to see all you here today on RIT Talk. We will talk today about ChatGPT's limitation in Java coding tasks. And our speaker today is my colleague, Denis Cetlakov. He's Senior Solution Architect at DataArt. So you can leave all your questions here in chat and our speaker will give answers to all of them. So, Denis, we can start.
Yep. Hello. Let me first talk about the origin of this talk. Like internally, there were like two discussions. Obvious discussion, which happens basically probably whole past year, that like ChatGPT finally will replace all developers and business can use ChatGPT to write the code. Another discussion was like from developers that coding is so complicated, ChatGPT never ever will replace us, so on and so forth. And there was another thread. Our recruiters ask like, what if candidates will use ChatGPT in order to, you know, solve coding tasks and they will cheat? Can we develop such tasks that are not solvable by ChatGPT? Together with my colleague, Andrei Sarokin, we decided to like think a little bit about this problem. We made a few sample tasks and we came to some interesting results, which I basically want to present you. Results are a little bit controversial, so answer is like an yes and no. So let's see what we have. Let me share you my screen. And which one? This one. Okay. If 2 seconds, you should be able to see it. So basically, and this is kind of the title of this presentation, I decided to ask ChatGPT to write some description for the given topic. This is description that we have. So basically it was produced by ChatGPT and put into a header of this presentation. I guess all people nowadays doing this. And by the way, if you have any questions or something, during the speech, please type in chat. For me, it's like way easier to answer on the go rather than like answering everything after the talk. Okay, so let's go. Let's then go to something practical. So like traditional task, FizzBuzz. So this is a task. I asked ChatGPT version 4, write a program that prints numbers from 1 to 100 and multiply, and for multiplies of 3 prints fees instead of number, and for multiplies of 5 prints bus. I guess like it's like this task is like probably 20 or 30 years old. Not a surprise, ChatGPT gave me pretty much a clean and sound solution for Java. So this is a solution. This is some textual explanation of like what's underscore, not a surprise at all. This was expected. So, okay, let's make our task a little bit more complicated. Let's add something. So basic task is the same, but input should be taken from a file, output should be written to a file. Input and output file names should be taken from command line parameters, lines in the input file and are comma separated. They could be white spaces, line breaks, number tabs that should be ignored. And last but not least, condition input file could be very big, up to dozens of gigabytes. This was given to ChatGPT. This is a solution that we have. Like this part is a little bit surprising. Like writing a program to process file of dozens of gigabytes is a significant task, which is beyond the capability of simple Java program. Well, this is kind of a surprise. I was under impression that it's fine, but okay, like let's look at the code. It's just an opinion. Blah, blah, blah. Huge scale data should be processed with Hadoop or Apache Spark. Okay, let's ignore it. What we have inside, so like input reader, output reader for input and output files. Then what's here? So we are reading the whole line. Then we are doing replace all for white spaces, then doing split with comma. And then basically this is like normal FizzBuzz implementation from the previous task. And then there is some wording which says, okay, of course, like file is too big, we must use Apache Spark or Linux Split or whatever. Like surprise, surprise, if you're doing like reading a huge file line by line and doing replace and doing split, probably it will fail with out of memory exception, because like the whole line could be like 12 gigabytes, obviously it will run out of memory. Yeah, what's wrong? The place with wrong, which is wrong, we are operating with like really, really huge data chunks using methods which are not applicable, like replace all, line split. Let's give a ChatGPT a hint. Please mind that one line may not fit in memory. Please rewrite having this in mind. Okay, like pretty much generic hint. What we have as a result? As a result, we have the following. So ChatGPT is reading like byte by byte. It's checking like character by character if it's like white space or not. So we, and basically again, we have here normal FizzBuzz nuts, but code is repeated twice. So what is wrong with this code? Any suggestions? I mean, it's almost fine. One small tiny caveat. I know there's delay between video and chat. Somebody is typing hello. Okay, hello. Caveats. Caveat is relatively small, so we are reading this like bytes as a character stream, which basically results in into some code duplication, right? Reading byte by byte is is inefficient. Yes, correct, but this is not a hint. No, basically we are not reading byte by byte because we are using buffer at reader. It reads like buffer by buffer, so it's not a case in this. Here, the case is that we are reading character, and this basically means some excessive load on CPU. So basically, again, when we are processing a really, really huge stream of data, excessive transformation back and forth could be a little bit expensive for CPU. So I gave another hint. Could you please move repetitive piece of code to a method and don't convert digit back and forth from byte to string and back? Actually, not to string, but to character, but whatever. Let's assume input file has ASCII encoding and all characters are one byte long. This is a solution. So what we have here? So we again reading with buffer, reading like operating digits. Doing some byte operations, ASCII to int. This is, by the way, hint by ChatGPT. So yes, solution is nice, really. So like it's operating, character codes and doing some pretty much interesting stuff. Yeah, and by the way, it made a good job, like moved a repetitive piece of code into a separate method. Okay, let's run this code. Let's run it. This is like input stream. This is output. What's wrong? It was not as a in the requirements, but data type, right? This is the right hint. So this number is like a little bit longer than just integer and even longer than long. Let's give one more hint. Some numbers may be very low, up to 100 digits. And by the way, don't use big integer class, because if you'll use big integer class, it will slow down program a lot. Again, you see, we have lots of non-functional stuff, which is could be relatively challenging even for, let's say, human Java developer. I could imagine none of all Java devs whom I know can solve this easily. Again, this solution was produced in 10 seconds, and you see what's here. And by the way, what is there like a smart way to check if number is divisible by 5 and 3? Type plus in chat who knows this by heart. Well, by 5, obviously, if it's end by 0 or 5, it's divisible. But how to check if it's like divisible by 3? Here is solution. And solution is fine, absolutely. At this point, I was expecting that ChatGPT will fail this. No, solution is fine. So it's like accumulating sum of characters, checking this sum. If it's divisible by 3, checking like digit. No, by 3, it works not the same way. Like if you need to check if number is divisible by 3, you need to sum up all digits. If result is divisible by 3, then the whole number is divisible by 3. That's it. And you see, solution is like ChatGPT takes this into account, like calculates sum, clean, nice, and sound solution. Really, it was impressive. I was under the impression that like somewhere near probably third or fourth hint, ChatGPT will give me something wrong, but this solution is really impressive. I mean, after giving some clarifications, I have pretty much clean and sound code. Yes, you need to provide some hints, but again, all solutions were compilable, runnable, absolutely fine. So then what, like ChatGPT will replace us? Ah! Okay, let's do something more complicated, less, let's say, theoretical. I mean, like, this is like clear number exercise. So we just, without any business requirements. So we are like formulating task in relatively pure mathematical terms. And solution is some like operating with some numbers again. Let's formulate solution in some business terms. Okay, formulate task. The task. Our company has a client from parallel magic world. Our client is Royal Bank of one of the kingdoms. We are automating some bank operations because they don't have computers and there's lots of space for automation. In that world, they have three currencies. First florin, then shard, moonstone. Shard, one shard is 8 florins, one moonstone is 13 shards. And they have like unit of weight, dragon scale, one dragon scale is blah, 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 something metric grams. One florin weights is 3 dragon scales, shard is 7 dragon scales, moonstone and 24 dragon scales. I'm intentionally formulating task in a like non-common, relatively theoretical, I mean, not common world terms. In this world, there are monster hunters who have a problem among others. When they kill a monster drops some coins, and because there is no credit cards, electronic payments, whatsoever, hunters need to carry all their cash in backpack. And it's obviously heavy. Like successful hunters, they need to carry a lot. And a bank wants to create a special bank product for hunters, a money weight optimization. So they bring lots of coins to bank. Bank gives them back the same, you know, amount of money, but optimize it by weight. For instance, they bring 14 florins, weight 45 dragon scales. They gave back 17 florins and 1 shards. And if I haven't made a mistake, like it should be 28 dragon scales. So it's like lighter. The task, create Java command line applications that accept 3 arguments, number of moonstones, shards, and florins. As an output, it should return optimized number of coins, like optimized by weight. Applications should also print weight for input and output in dragon scales. This is the task. To be honest with you, this sounds like a relatively decent interview task. And like in my career, interviewed probably 100 plus people. And I swear not all of them will solve this, at least in a reasonable amount of time. By the way, like type in chat who understand how to solve this like right now on the spot. I mean, without additional Googling, thinking, whatever. Just, you know, I'm just curious. Type something plus in chat or whatever. Nobody. Oh, it's a delay. Okay, I see at least someone understands. So basically, solution is relatively simple. We need to normalize everything to Florins, and then, yes, like use module calculation and calculate the rest of the, like, the rest parts. This is a solution from ChatGPT. You see, there are like constant Florin value, chart value, moonstone value, weights, and basically, this line is the essence of the solution. So you see, like, calculate weight in florins, and then value in florins, sorry, and then just optimize by dividing by like value of moonstones, then by value of shards, and printing output. So basically, this is the solution. Like everything here, just a few lines, relatively simple. Again, and I suspect this is kind of a relatively standard task. Again, probably for interviews, so solution seems to be pretty much robust and automated. Okay, again, it was easy, but it was, again, it was nice. Let's make task a little bit, yeah, and by the way, one point that I was surprised, actually. So you see, this is like Magical Kingdom, Parallel World, Monster Hunters, like Backpack, whatever, like lots of business meet, like really lots of, and ChatGPT managed to extract essence of it, like really, like, okay, we have floor, we have coins, it understand like value of coins, you see, it understand like florin, the smallest one. It's amazing, come on, really amazing, like I was surprised. My original idea when I just started like playing with it, like my idea was that if I'll give too much noisy input and to like make it too complicated in terms of business, like bring some like fantasy stuff, it will fail. No, you see, it works really. So we have relatively long task. I mean, in terms of number of tokens, and we have nice and sound solution, like which actually hits the essence of the task. It's really great. Okay, but let's make it a little bit more complicated. What we have changed? First of all, shards to florins are converted like not one to many. So it's like three shards are 17 florins, six moonstones are 23 shards. And last but not least, shard is 37 dragon scales, which basically means that three shards are heavier than 17 florins. This is a requirement. So it doesn't make sense to convert money to shards at all, because like shards, it's too heavy. The rest of the task is the same. So what we have here? Here we have like input stuff, some optimized coins, output. Let's see how it, like, again, what it's doing. It's converting everything to florins, and it completely ignores the fact that shards, like we need three shards to convert to florin, like zero knowledge here, you see. And the rest of the solution basically is the same. So once we ignore the fact that three shards are 17 florins, solution is useless. We see like the bug is like relatively obvious. So I'm giving a hint. If you take input 1, 4, 18 gives output blah, blah, blah. So I pointed the fact that there is no, it's not correct because 17 florins are three shards. I haven't pointed the fact that shards are heavier than florins, by the way. Money Optimizer version 2. Again, solution is reworked, but this is kind of variation of original one. So my input was not taken into account. Explanation is something. So you program with input, blah, 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 should correctly output something, blah, blah, blah. But this is actual output, you see. Like one moonstone, three shards, one florin, weight, 178. But after I run program, actual output is not the same as output from ChatGPT. So it starts giving me some bullshit. And by the way, this is like actual solution just for the case. So for this input, so 1 for 18. And yeah, this was made in Excel. And this is like optimized weight. Okay, I gave another hint. Please mind that three shards are heavier than 17 florins. Final solution from ChatGPT. The program, blah, 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 convert everything to florins. This like original, when I just read it, this text seems to me kind of reasonable. I mean, really. I read, yeah, like it finally got the idea. Come on, blah, blah, blah. Then I read it once and again and once again, and I understand that basically this text looks reasonable, but it's not. It still ignores the fact that three shards are heavier than 17 florins. So my hint was kind of ignored. And this is final solution. Again, this is variation of original one. It completely ignores hints. It completely ignores the fact that shards are heavier than florins. And the output is, you see, like non-correct. Again, it was nice to some point originally, but then once I start giving hints, and I believe these hints were out of normal, let's say, material that was used to educate ChatGPT, and it like missed completely. So last three options, last two options, was like literally bullshit. So what we have here, let me scroll up again. So once we have requirement that requires some thinking, so we need to say, oh yeah, by the way, shards are heavier, and by the way, three shards are 17 florins, not one shard. ChatGPT start ignoring them and start giving us pretty much nice but wrong solutions. So again, like end of dialogue, once I start giving more and more hints, is absolutely irrelevant. Like, I mean, like irrelevant completely. So my intention was to play a little bit with it, but again, I found that it probably doesn't make sense, as you can see. So, okay, let's play with some different task. Because I understand this task probably is not very algorithmic, not much things to calculate, not much things to code. Let's give something which requires more coding, which more algorithmic like, more about programming. Okay, next task. We are building software for space colony ship. Ship has landed on a rocky area, sometimes flooded with water. We have area map. And by the way, this is kind of, if you're interested in such kind of stuff, there is event which happens in December, which is called Advent of Code. No, I haven't tried 17/3 florins. Probably will do this after IT talk, whatever. So by the way, if you're interested in such tasks, there is event which is called Advent of Code, AOC. You may easily Google it. And normally like somewhere in December, there is a series of tasks that you need to solve daily. And it's pretty much interesting, like highly recommended as a, like, you know, fun stuff. Okay, so let's go back to our space colony. So we have space colony landed on distant planet. This is map. Ship is indicated by this sharp symbol. And numbers from 0 to 8 is terrain square, where number reflects height of the square above, you know, zero level. Height is from 0 is 0 meters, like 1 is 10 meters, it is 80 meters from base level. And Sharp is colony ship, which is like 200 meters high. The task. Develop a Java command line program that takes file name with terrain as a first input. Flood level in meters could be from 0 to 80 as a second input. And output the original web map where squares that are suitable for building houses are marked by this, what is the name of this symbol, at. Square is suitable for building a house if it is not flooded and is reachable from colony ship without colony ship on ground, I mean like in a walkable, without swimming. For instance, for a given map and flood level 15, the result should be, you see, so basically all numbers which are below, which are above 15 meters and reachable from ship are replaced by this at symbol. So basically these places are, spots are buildable. Okay, solution. And I omitted a text explanation just, you know, for the sake of readability. But ChatGPT clearly indicates algorithm names that should be used to solve this problem. And it's basically used pretty much interesting solution with directions and queue. So if I were like solving this, I will probably will do this in a less interesting way. So basically it reads map, you see, then it converts map to using like two characters, finds ship position, marks buildable area by navigating through array, through like a queue of directions, queue of positions, sorry, and moving to each direction from a queue, marking places as visited. And again, like it's a really nice solution. I like it a lot. If I were like writing this on the spot, I would probably write something like not that nice looking, really. So it works. I checked. And by the way, interesting point. ChatGPT even provided me with like pseudocode. And it was able to read this like array of symbols into like map into array of numbers. And again, this is really impressive. I was under the impression that it wouldn't be solvable. Probably again, this is pretty much standard task. But the way how it read it from a file is really something that I have not expected. So it understands like relation between terrain square and number, put it into this condition check, you see. Okay, it's checking condition. Again, really great. Okay, let's make this task a little bit more complicated. Just add one relatively small complication. Everything is the same, sorry, but square is suitable for building a house if it's not flooded and we can build a road to the square. A road is buildable only between colony ship and any square near the ship and between squares which with height difference smaller or equal to 10. You understand, if there is like too like high cliff or pit, you cannot build the road. So you can build the road only if inclination of a road is small enough. So you can build a road, for instance, between 2 and 1, 1 and 0, 4 and 5, but you cannot build the road between like 5 and 3, for instance, because inclination is like difference is 2. Pretty much easy. You see, for instance, for a given map, you see from ship, we can go to these two squares, we can go to 5 and 5, but we cannot jump from 5 to 2. And we can go from 5 to 4, from 4 to 3, and that's it. We cannot jump from 3 to 1. And by the way, 1 is flooded. So we still cannot go there, and we cannot jump from 4 to 2. So this is like the target map that I expected to be built. Requirement again is not really, really complicated, as you can see. So just easy to check. You check 2 nearby squares, and if you can build a road, you can you mark it as a like a buildable. This is a solution. Again, it kind of takes into account requirements. So let's go to like find ship location again is like easy one. Mark square buildable. It walks through the map in the same way with Q and directions from here. So basically solution is the same. The essence of this is this function. So it checks if square is valid and it checks flood level. Let's see how it checks if square is valid. So it checks, like road is checked here. That road is buildable is checked here. Yeah, here it is. Sounds reasonable, right? So if there is different less than or equals than 10, then we can build and yeah, why not? I tried to run this program. I found that I basically code is not compilable. Surprise. Like this was the first time I found that ChatGPT provides me with non-compilable code. I made a hint, lined, blah, 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 gave compilation error. Solutions, like changed. This was a proposed change. Okay, still not compilable. I made a second hint. Line for care, blah, 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 gives compilation error. I was provided with updated code. Here it is. With this change, program was compilable. I was able to run it. And here is solution. What's wrong? Well, who can tell? Well, obviously wrong, like the fact that we don't have buildable squares at all, but the reason is quite simple. Any guesses? Yeah, I understand that reading program from my screen when I'm scrolling up and down could be quite complicated. So I don't expect you to, you know, analyze it on the fly. So basically the problem is that ChatGPT ignores the fact that squares between a colony ship and any other adjustment square is like buildable. So ship is high and you can build a road from ship to any square. So I gave a hint. Squares to left and to the right from the ship are definitely okay for building the road because they are not flooded and directly connected to the ship. See rule colony ship and any square like near the ship, you can build a road there. This is a solution. And by the way, ChatGPT excused and said, oh yeah, by the way, I missed the fact that it's squares near the ship are buildable. And here is a correction. So again, this comment came from ChatGPT. Mark squares directly adjustment to the ship as buildable. Here they are, you see. And it's used a function as valid. So again, like nice reusable code. I like it very much. Then like continue BFS, it builds something, output is still strange. Like, you see, there are just 2 buildable squares, while 5 should be definitely buildable. I mean, what's the problem? And it took me I started looking at the code. It took me probably 5 minutes and using debugger to understand where the problem is. The problem is relatively simple. So because you don't have debugger and you don't have IDE handy, I'll explain. So basically, this is a check. Where we're checking that we can build the road. Here it is. Let me mark it. And the trick is that ChatGPT is changing the same map array on the fly. So it's like replacing characters in this array. And so basically, once it understands that this square is buildable, it replaced 5 with that symbol. And code, like ASCII code of the symbol, is definitely not 5. And then it's checking a difference in ASCII code between these characters. And it's, I forgot actually the code, but it's like more than 100, like difference is huge. What does it mean? It means that once we, how we can solve this? What is the essence of the problem? So once we start modifying map, we need to check buildability of the map. We need to have two arrays, original one and output array. And ChatGPT ignores this fact and start modifying original array. Probably because the task that it is like having in mind have this original array, have this like one array solution in mind. And that's why all solutions that it provides afterwards view like after this like hint, I tried giving several hints regarding like the direction, but all solutions were like kind of non-compilable or just strange. So relatively after this point, it broke. I mean, like it started giving me anything meaningful. So that's why I haven't provided it, because it was really nasty. Yeah, it is like a child, it is. I'm trying to remember how we were like studying programming when I was in university, and some students in our group probably were like doing something similar. So my understanding, like ChatGPT, let's say, kinda knows programming language, but he doesn't know how to program. Really, like by program, I mean, you know, building some algorithm, building some data manipulations. So once you give him like simple task, just manipulate data in obvious, like take it from here, put it there, you know, like carry task, it can solve the problem. If it can identify the algorithm again, it can solve the problem. If it's something beyond standard algorithm, it starts giving you some real bullshit. Sorry, pardon my French. And even with hints, you cannot make it solve, provide you some real, real interesting stuff. So again, this is at this point I stopped. Again, ChatGPT may give you like a nice clean code. Really, some of this solution, as I said, like really, really impressive. But the problem is that this code can ignore some critical requirements. Let's go to this example with bank. So it completely ignores the fact that like shard is heavier than like than 17, three shards is heavier than 17 florins. This is kind of like common sense, and there is no common sense in ChatGPT. That's my takeaway. So if you need something which requires common sense, probably ChatGPT will not help you. Again, checking that code works correctly could be challenging. So I was reading this like the last solution. Once I have it, I was reading it without launching, and like it works, like it should be fine. I read all through, and it looks for me, it looks like clean and sound before I run it. Once I run it, I understand, oh yeah, by the way, there is a bug somewhere, and I was not even able to find the bug. And it took me, 5 minutes and debugger like in order to find where the problem is. At the same point, ChatGPT recognized the task pretty much well. It was about like space travel, colony, something, and it's a flood, a water level, and said like, this is like algorithm that you should use. This is like quote from ChatGPT. And again, this is impressive, amazing. So you definitely can use ChatGPT as a, like, I don't know, internet on steroids. So you need to search for something, and you need to understand like body of the problem. So what class of problem do we have here? And if you need to do it, like ChatGPT definitely helps. Reusing code as is definitely will not, because the problem is like code looks nice, At the same time, it may contain bugs and it may ignore some critical requirements, and it's hell easy to understand it until you test it. And not always tests are easy. So sometimes testing this could be, again, quite challenging. Together with my colleagues, we made a few more tasks, and a pattern is the same. So once you hit something really simple and let's say existing in let's say internet, like as a solution, ChatGPT provides you pretty much nice clean code. Once you start, if you want to alter your code by providing some direct changes, like we did with this with FizzBuzz for big files, it is relatively following your instructions. But once you hit some tricky requirements, you need to provide algorithm literally like step by step, take this, put there. At the same time, it may do some common trivial tasks really, really impressive. Really, I was really impressed how it read the map, how it did manipulations with files, identified the way how we can, find that number is divisible by 3 or 5. Again, this is really great. But once you need common sense and some analysis of critical requirements or non-functional pieces, it fails, and the problem, it doesn't say, oh, no, I don't know how to solve this. No, it says, like, this is a solution, use it. This is the most frightening part. I must have which version of it is like, yeah, I haven't said it's ChatGPT-4. I decided to use ChatGPT. Well, ChatGPT-3 start failing somewhere in the middle of FizzBuzz, to be honest with you. So it's not very useful for coding. It was version 4. I have another experiment in mind, find some language, programming language, or probably create some new language spec based on, I don't know, probably take some basic dialect, like something simple, or NIM or something, which fits probably 1 or 2 pages of text, and ask ChatGPT to write something using like new, not some programming language, which is not known by ChatGPT. My expectation, it will fail completely. But I tried this before this, talk, but I found that create like my own language spec is a little bit challenging. And finding something easily, usable, again, I was not able to find something which I can use as is. So this is like advanced task. I'll probably do it somewhere in August. Basically, that's it. I am ready to answer your questions if you have some, or we can wrap here. Any suggestions? One, two, three, four, five. They say there is like 15 seconds delay. Any real impact on software developers market you could call out, given the ChatGPT seems to act as a nice helper that may probably replace junior positions? The problem is, as I said, like if it said, okay, I don't know how to solve this, sorry. It's fine, it could be usable, but it always gives you a solution. That's a problem. And you need to find the bug in this solution. So I don't expect it to replace, well, obviously it depends on sense of junior, I don't expect a replacement somewhere soon, at least with the current state. I definitely expect it could be used if you need to do some advanced, problem solving. So you can, use like ChatGPT is like kind of collective memory or collective mind of all humankind. And if you need to solve some tricky problem, you may say something like, I have such a problem. What is like problem space? Can you give me a hint if something exists in this area? I could expect it could produce a huge help. Probably the solution. Provide probability that solution is correct. Obviously, it is current probabilities. Well, yeah, you may play with it. Like, as I said, like, as you can see, I played with FizzBuzz on steroids and start providing more and more and more hints. And at some point I have pretty much good solution. But the problem is that, again, with more complicated methods, I tried to nail it down with advanced bank. And I found that I'm spending like way more time trying to give hints rather than like writing solution on my own. That's the main problem. So like again, I spend probably half an hour giving different hints, and I end up in some complete bullshit. So it was worse and worse and worse, like worse than the original one. So again, it's like a good search engine, but it rather gives you good code at the beginning, or hints will like can drive you to somewhere like strange place. DeepMind demonstrate code AI with some nice features up to multi-file editing, bug fixing. I'm really curious to see that in action. Well, actually, to be honest with you, my task was not to demonstrate capabilities of AI. If I were like, my desire was to demonstrate how ChatGPT is amazing and can solve the problem, I definitely could do this. Come on, I could, for instance, we have this island task. I may stop here and do not do like next advanced task. If I stop there, it would be amazing. Come on. My idea is to find the limits. And I was able to find limits probably in 2 hours. That's the problem. So all these presentations with demonstration how ChatGPT or DeepMind is amazing, take it with a pinch of salt, really. Until you tried it yourself, I probably wouldn't trust it again. As you can see, FizzBuzz was amazing. Bank Advanced was miserable, really. Difference is like half an hour of building requirements. Let me read through questions. Does it provide a way to connect my code instead of just provide a code to check and improve? Well, to correct, yeah, it can correct your code. I made another task, which is not here actually. I provided some code pieces and asked to reuse methods which generates data structures in order to do something with some transformation of these data structures, and it used the code. So yeah, it could manipulate your code, so, and it may fix something in it. So again, it's possible, but again, there are limits. The limits are like devil is in details. When you start having some non-trivial requirements, you'll hit this limit. Another question. Did you try some prompt engineering techniques to guide generation, like chain of thoughts of passing few short examples to the model? I tried a little bit. I heard about these techniques, but again, I found that for me it's like way more complicated rather than providing a solution. Sorry, like obviously when you do, let's say, programming part for ChatGPT, probably provide some pseudocode or something, it may pick it up and build your real code. So there is some use, but for me, it's like non-convenient way of programming. Rather than using like direct way, you try and, you know, to proxy your train of thoughts. Yeah, it could be impressive, but I don't see real use in it. It's more likely that would be a good power to junior rather than a placement senior devs well of themselves. Well, replacing junior developers drives us to a very interesting question in software development. Who is actually a junior developer? And notion of junior developer is so different between different projects and companies. I definitely don't want to deep dive here. So just a few comments. Like when I was in university, like first year, we were studying like some programming language and doing some very, very, very basic stuff. If statements like cycles, so on and so forth. Once we started it, we start studying like real programming, like what was before, it was just, you know, programming language. I normally expect that junior developer from probably fourth grade can do programming and can do some algorithms. But again, taking into account current state of IT industry, this notion could be very, very different. And I don't want to go this way, at least in terms of this talk. If you take a junior developer, well, okay. I guess I can tell. We made an experiment with my colleagues. We started this activity probably a month ago. And we took, because there was an intention, not an intention, but like discussed an ability to use this task for interviews. We took this task and gave them to real developers who were not engaged in the current programs and like just ask them to solve the task. And record solve time, like how much did they spend solving the task. And one of the tasks was this bank advanced, and one was, which I haven't shown during this talk. Results were pretty much controversial. I don't remember exact numbers, but it was something like 4 developers solved this in 3 to 4 hours. And this is kind of normal expectation. So you're relaxed, you're not in projects, you have something optional, you drink coffee, do some relaxed coding. Okay, 3 to 4 hours is fine. I mean, I probably expect shorter period, but whatever. One of them solved, like for one of them, it took 25 hours to solve the task, which is a lot and definitely shows some gap in skill level. And it was not correlated with actually grade. Which gives us sense that grade is more like nowadays, developer's grade is more ability to operate with existing frameworks, libraries, tooling, talk on standups, rather than solve algorithms. And this is kind of our reality. So pretty much often you really need a guy who understands that particular framework, but who probably cannot do some solve some complex algorithms. Mentioned correctly, is like exist any special approach or specified task in the most proper way to ChatGPT would provide more detailed and proper solution. Oh. Well, if I got answer from Anton correctly, is there are there any, let's say, search techniques how you can make ChatGPT gives you better result? It's not really clear based on what task input conditions are not taken into consideration. Well, it's another interesting topic. I read it in news. There is kind of early day profession like neural network operator, someone who knows how to ask right questions to neural networks and take better results from them. Probably, I guess it's too early for us to decide. If you look at images generated by neural network, like Stable Diffusion, Mind Journey, Leonardo AI, there's there, and you read some blogs, you find that there is like a community of people who are using special settings combining plugins, combining hints whatsoever in order to produce better results. There is definitely body of knowledge here. And studying more and more, you probably will get like better and better results. Yeah, prompt engineering, right, this is the name. Interesting fact that I read a book, there is a book by Robert Heinlein, which is called Moon is a Harsh Mistress. And in that book, there was a central computer on the moon base, and there was a set of operators who were literally explaining to this computer what it needed to solve. So kind of this profession was predicted by sci-fi authors, writers. And I believe probably in future there is a space for such prompt engineering. Name would be probably more glorious. But yeah, giving right hints requires some skill set, which I don't have, to be honest with you. I played with this probably for a few days. But again, is it possible to give enough hints to solve this task? Definitely yes, yes. Can we do this in a larger scale, or can we do this faster? I don't know. Should a prompt engineer who generates code be able to program? I believe yes. So if you don't know Java, I don't think you'll be able to generate enough prompts to create a right program. And again, the main problem with the current, let's say, what is called weak AI that I foresee, is that you cannot verify a solution. It's not verifiable. It gives you something, it's very difficult to understand, is it the right decision solution or not? And again, in some cases, it took you like a relatively long time to understand, is there a bug and where a bug is. That's the main problem I foresee. Yes, this is like a really nice tool. Again, I wish I can use it more frequently or freely. For instance, there are some cases when I need to understand what is the name for a problem. And it looks like it clearly can give it to you. So for instance, what a problem I am solving can tell you, you are solving you need to use that algorithm, or you are solving the problem of name tokenization, please look at this and that framework. Really great, this is what I need. And looks like ChatGPT at current state can definitely provide you with this information. But taking it without like any post correction, I don't see how it could be used. Again, nice tool to play, but nice toy to play, but not in the current state. Okay, looks like we run out of questions, and I guess we can wrap here. 1 hour, this is kind of nice limit for a talk. Any more options, questions, suggestions?
Yes, so I guess it's all the questions for now. So thanks everyone to join us today, and we are waiting on you and others, our events.
Thank you.
Thank you.